A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 4th November, on the front page you have Delhi chokes as air pollution levels hit a 3-year high. So some weather models have said that the plume could move to South India. So this polluted air could move to South India is now a cause of concern too. So you can see the how the region is blanketed by smog. So cities across northern and eastern parts of India are choked due to air pollution. And here you have Priyanka Gandhi was warned by WhatsApp, says Congress. So party spokesperson of Congress has accused government of using Israeli software to snoop on citizens. So this we have already seen the Pegasus software of Israeli NSO group, which it claims was is used by government agencies across the world. And this is odd even scheme returns to city today. So Delhi has brought in odd even scheme. 200 traffic points have been identified to ensure efficient implementation of scheme as well. And this is NRC exercise only to update 1951 list. So Chief Justice of India Ranjan Gogoi has said that the Assam NRC process meant to identify illegal migrants residing in the border state was neither a new nor a novel idea, but only an attempt to update the 1951 list of NRC, National Register of Citizens. And below you have Home Ministry warns of lone wolf attacks by IS operatives. So high alert has been issued to all states ahead of Republic Day on 26 January that lone wolf attacks by Islamic State operatives targeting high-risk dignitaries in the can take place in the run-up to Republic Day celebrations. On page 8, you have 500 passenger trains get ISRO-enabled GPS. So about 500 passenger locomotives of South Central Railway have been fitted with the newly developed real-time train information system, RTIS, to monitor precise speeds and movements throughout the journey from first point to the destination. So this RTIS has been developed by Center for Railway Information System with the help of Indian Space Research Organization. So it takes a ISRO Air Input Authority of India's Gagan Global Positioning System aided geo-augmented navigation has been used for RTIS. So we have already seen GPS, Gagan. So Gagan stands for Global Positioning System aided geo-augmentation. So this was originally developed for air traffic management, but now this has been used for railways as such. Then this is Amravati missing a new map of India. So the redrawn political map of India, which was released by the center depicting the newly formed union territories of Jammu and Kashmir and Ladakh, have no mention of Amravati as the capital of Andhra Pradesh. So this reinforces the claim of the ruling YSR Congress that previous TDP government had not notified Amravati as the capital of the state. And in the new map, Hyderabad is shown as the common headquarter, common capital. And this is protest against plan for high-rise at Kubban Park. So hundreds of workers joined hands against move to build High Court annex on park premises. So this is Kubban Park in Bengaluru. On page 9, you have an interview with VP, Vice President of Vital Strategies, which is a global public health organization. It is just appreciating and saying that more countries are regulating and banning e-cigarettes, and the ban imposed in India on e-cigarettes will help prevent its use among the youth. And below you have Army to have first Dhanush regiment by March 2020. So this is India's indigenously upgraded Dhanush artillery gun. So it is said the first regiment will be in place by March 2020 and the entire order of 114 guns of the army will be completed by 2022. So this is indigenously upgraded variant of Swedish Bofors gun, which was imported in 1980s. And you should know that this has been undertaken by Ordnance Factory Board, OFB, not DRDO. So that's important because generally when questions come, so questions will interchange. There will be two statements with some term interchange, some word interchange. So you should know it's not DRDO, it's Ordnance Factory Board, which is upgrading Dhanush. And this is ISRO's Navik set to be commercialized by Antariksh. So Indian Space Research Organization and its commercial arm, Antariksh Corporation Limited, are planning to commercialize India's regional navigation satellite system, that is Navik. Antariksh recently floated two separate tenders to identify industries that can develop dedicated Navi-based hardware and systems. So this is a boat you can see carrying a Navic receiver, which is setting out for trials at Kerala's Vizhinjam port harbor. Then below you have BSF tracks earth, water and air on Bangladesh border. So recently acquired Israeli tethered drones and thermal imagers aid operation in challenging riverine terrain across the India-Bangladesh border. So border security force has literally gone underground and is keeping a watch on trafficking in the region as such along the border. It has its eyes in the sky, underground as such too. So this is through these drones which have been procured. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Pegasus misadventure. So this is regarding the spyware of Israeli-based group NSO, which has been accused by WhatsApp to be used on its app and snooping on various human rights activists, lawyers, etc. has been undertaken, journalists. So the editorial says that government must clarify whether it deployed spyware to snoop on its critics or not. So the government of India has not given its statement on that aspect, whether it has used this software or not. Then next is a test and a chance. So this is regarding Jharkhand elections. It says BJP's poll machine will be tested in Jharkhand, giving the Congress a chance to return. So after Haryana and Maharashtra, now Jharkhand Legislative Assembly elections are scheduled, and how BJP fares in that is to be seen. The lead article, Intransigence as a Villain of the Peace. So this is regarding Nagaland, Naga issue. So it says, in Nagaland, aspirations of a new era can seldom be seen from an aging fixed vision. And the NSC and IM, which is in talks with central government now, must recognize this. That's an old demand which it is making of greater Nagaland. So, and it is becoming the villain of peace. Intransigence means not ready to change. So it is, there are new aspirations, new era. So it should also change its demand. And this is the crisis in Dalit Bahujan politics. So this is how the right wing has appropriated caste-based politics with more representation to backward classes, but no robust social agenda. So it is giving representation to them, but for their annihilation, for their enhancer, for their bringing them up, you know, emancipation, no steps, no social agenda is in place. Then on the op-ed page, you have this article, Privatization is not the question. So this is regarding Telangana State Road Transport Corporation strike, which has been going on for a month now as such. So it's entered its 20th day on November 2. So it's been 30 days now. So the discussion in Telangana, the article says, should focus on ways of revitalizing the State Road Transport Corporation. Because State Road Transport Corporation is under stress, 48,000 employees as such, which are represented by this joint action committee, are protesting, but Telangana government is not ready to give in. So what steps need to be taken is being discussed here. The demand of employees is that Telangana State Road Transport Corporation should be merged with the government, because they fear that privatization may take place later, which would affect them, and their jobs layout would take place. They would be losing their jobs as such, and the security. So this is the issue. So here the article says that privatization is not the question. If State Road Transport Corporation is revitalized, if it functions well, then there's no question of, employees not being happy. Then this is Been a Witness Builds Trust. So this is regarding editorial meetings. You can skip this. And this is, again, you can skip this, extrajudicial killings which are taking place in BJP-led states. So then on page 12, you have alerted government in September 2, says WhatsApp. So when WhatsApp has accused that, the NSO group's Pegasus software has been used against human rights activists by governments. So now government of India has on its part accused WhatsApp of not informing it of such breach. And WhatsApp in its response now says that it has alerted the government. It had earlier said it had alerted the government in May. And now it says in September 2, we had alerted the government. Then on page 13 you have fear, cold and lack of workforce, workers to leave Kashmir. So in Jammu and Kashmir presently, after Article 370 has been revoked, special status has been lost. Previously workers who are engaged in construction and fruit picking, they are finding it tough now. So steadily migrant workers are exiting the Kashmir Valley. And this is Jammu and Kashmir to shift political detainees during winter. So 34 leaders who are held in Sanchar Hotel will be shifted during winter in Jammu and Kashmir. And this is new Indian demands may stall RCEP deal. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi is in Thailand for the RCEP summit. And he said that he made no mention of signing the pact as such. So there are new demands which India has made now, which may further delay the RCEP. And then you have India-Uzbekistan ink three defense deals. So Defense Minister Rajnath Singh is on a visit to Uzbekistan here, and India and Uzbekistan have signed three MOUs to enhance cooperation in military medicine and military education during Defense Minister's visit. Also, bilateral consultation as such took place, after which they jointly presided over a curtain raiser of first India-Uzbekistan joint exercise, which will be called Dustlik 2019. India has also offered a concessional line of credit of $40 million for procurement of goods and services by Uzbekistan from India. On international page again, you have news regarding Hong Kong protests, and here you have in world's biggest listing, Saudi Aramco to float IPO. So this is part of Saudi Arabia's plan to diversify its economy. It is kickstarting its initial public offering. So it announced its intention to float on the domestic stock exchange, what would be the world's biggest listing. So this is regarding Aramco. Aramco is the world's most profitable company. It offered few specifics on the number of shares to be sold, the pricing or the date for launch. But this announcement has been made. Then on Sundays on the business page, you have money-wise coverage, which is on individual economic planning. So that's not important. So that is it. These were the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website asr.com. Also, detailed current affairs video is available, but that is a separate course, the details of which you will find on our website. Thank you.